Hello everybody, it's that one guy here, and today I figured I would do a tutorial on how to fly low tier Russian planes. Now if you're like me, you have no clue how to fly these darn things. You had no clue. You start off and you have no clue how to fly these things, because they're quite complicated. They got big old cannons in the middle, and that's about it. So I'm here to show you how to fly these darn things, because they are darn complicated. Well, not that, it's actually not that complicated. So what you want to do is you just kind of want to follow these guys. You want to use your rudder, and you don't want to get into dogfights with anyone. You can't win those, especially with British planes. And then you just want to use your rudder to turn, because you lose very minimal speed when you use your rudder. If you look up in the top left corner, when I use my rudder, I slow down very slowly. But if I use the turning, then I slow down really fast. So you just want to keep using the rudder to turn, and you want to keep as much speed as possible, so that way they can't keep up with you. So let's try and go after this I-185. Because Russian planes are very fast, and so you want to use that to your advantage. Oh, he just crashed. Okay. So we are going to go for this darn Spitfire then. Oh dear, oh dear, oh! Got him, but he got me. I think that was the one with the 20 mils. I'm not certain though. No, it could have been the one with 20 mils. So, we're going to use the Yak one next. So, we just got to use the rudder to turn, and we just got to make sure we keep our speed up. Now, you might want to climb a little bit at the beginning of a battle as to gain some energy for that initial chase down. And then, once you're ready, you just choose a target and go after them. And then, if they start to chase you, don't worry. Just try and avoid their shots a little bit. Don't go like this, you know. That's going to slow you down really fast. You just want to keep your energy up. And you just want to make sure they don't get faster than you. That's just the honest truth here. Now some of you may be thinking, well, that's how it is with every country. Well, Britain is completely different. You want to try and drag people into dogfights, so that way you have the turning advantage here. And my cannon overheated. So don't lose too much speed. I just lost about 50 there. So we are gonna go for this Focke-Wulf. Actually, no, don't hit on Focke-Wulfs. That's a bad idea. I just realized how terrible of an idea that was. Oh, he's turning around. Yeah, just keep going. He totally does not have enough speed to catch me. You can see we're gaining a distance between us and him. So don't freak out. We're Russians, and we go fast, and our friend will take him out over there. There's somebody over this hill. It's an HE-112. Don't let this guy drag us into a dogfight. No, he crashed. Okay. All the other planes seem to be above us, so we are gonna climb a little bit here. We're gonna come help this B-25 out. All right, come here. We are losing massive amount. Oh, okay. We were losing massive amounts of speed, and then he died. So let's not go down for no reason. All right. I am not hitting these shots very well. Nope, kill assist. Okay, let's go after this LA-5. Oh my gosh, this thing has like zero guns. Yep, and he's dead. And that was a kill assist. And now we gotta wait for these long reloads. Is that the dead guy? Or is that actually someone that's behind me? Oh, that is the dead guy, okay. So we're gonna come over here because there's some targets over here. It's a Halifax. Wait. Okay, yeah, no, we're good. Go get this guy. Actually, he has a lot of guys on his tail already. Where are all the enemies? Because there's, like, hardly any of them on the map right now. So I guess they're all over here defending their base. So we'll go pay them a visit. Hellcat, two BF-109s, and a P-39N, and LA-7 coming in. Is that BF-109? Yeah, the BF-109 is coming after me, I think. So, we're just gonna slowly avert their shots. So, LA-7 is also coming after me. Not gonna head on this guy. Heading on is a bad idea when you're going against Germans. And we got that guy. That counts for anything. You got two kills in this thing? Okay. No, we didn't. No, we did. What the? Okay, we'll have to check that in just a second. So now let's take out the Yak-7B. Hopefully we can do good in this. Oh shoot, I should have changed the ammo type. Yeah, I guess we got two in that one. Don't remember getting a kill. It's probably on the HE-112. Yeah, we'll leave him be. He's got a lot of bad guys on him. Sorry, good guys. We're gonna go after this Doe 217. Actually, no, we'll go after the Yak-9 back here. Save our buddy. A painful death. This he is very locked in on this 217. Make sure you guys don't tunnel. It's a really bad thing. You got a hit. Nothing really important though. So we're just gonna turn with the rudder. As you can see, we still have over 300 miles per hour of speed. We'll go after this I-16. Something's shooting at us. There we go. I got you, bud. So now we're just gonna keep on cruising along, and that Spitfire will not be able to catch us. We have somebody behind us, though. I don't know what it is. Just give me a second, turning around here, and I'll check. I think he's above me. Oh no, he died, probably. So as you can see, I'm just making sure that my plane doesn't roll, because they generally tend to lose a lot of speed when they roll. It's just a Russian characteristic. Seems Yak-9 is going after this PBJ. Don't think we're going to be able to catch him in time. I feel like going after some ground targets, so... I think, yeah, the PBJ is turning around, so we should be able to surprise this Yak-9 if the game stops freezing. Okay, we got him. Pull up. Alright. That was some good head-on right there. And now we're gonna go over here and get this Yak-9. Well, I got a critical. I don't know what I crit. Oh, it was a kill assist. Darn. Well, we got two kills on that one. Not bad. We are in third place. Wow. So we'll use this Yak 311. That's not a Yak. We will grab some rockets here. Okay. Oh, those are tiny and pathetic. I thought those were gonna be bigger. They're not like British rockets, that's for sure. Yeah, we'll go help this A673 with this Yak and JU88. For some reason, I want to say Yak all of a sudden.
Yak!
Oh. Well, we won. So, that, my friends, is how you fly Russian planes. Not too hard. You just gotta make sure you use that rudder to turn. And if somebody starts. Like, if you attack, go to attack somebody, totally mess up your attack. Just keep flying. Don't stop to don't try and turn around to attack them again. Just keep going. Eventually they'll probably give up because you're too fast. They won't be able to catch up with you. And yeah. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. I'm going to try and get more of these War Thunder tutorials out. And subscribe. Bye.